let's take a look at how the warping function works within the simpler device. You may already be familiar with the warp mode, which you can use with audio clips in Live. As of Live 9.5, the warp mode has also been introduced to the simpler device so that you can use warping with samples as well as all the different algorithms. Let's take a look at how the warp mode works in the simpler device. The warp mode allows me, in this case, to play a sample at the same pitch and change the project tempo, or to maintain a project tempo and change the pitch. I can play this drum loop and change the project tempo to see how the warping affects the sample that I've loaded into the simpler device. I can also maintain the tempo and change the pitch of the drums that I'm playing. Another way of making use of the warp function is by playing sounds polyphonically that may have been originally monophonic. In this particular MIDI track, I have a simpler device loaded with a synthesizer loop. And if I play this back now polyphonically, all the notes will be in sync and play together. Let's have a listen to what this would sound like if the warp mode is switched off. The synth loop on its own, monophonically, and now polyphonically as three notes play together. You can clearly hear the difference of what happens when the warp mode is switched on and off when playing back samples. To further expand on the topic of warping, let's just briefly go over the different warp algorithms that you can use in the simpler device to play back your samples. The algorithms can be used to best fit the samples that you've loaded into the simpler device. The beats mode algorithm works best for samples where rhythm is the dominant factor of the sonic material. In this particular simpler device, I have a drum loop loaded. The tones mode algorithm is used for samples which have more or less a clear pitch. Examples of this would be things like vocals, monophonic instruments, or bass lines. In this case, I have a monophonic oscillator sample. The texture mode works best for sounds which have an ambiguous pitch contour or a polyphonic. In this case, I have a pad sound. So the complex algorithm is good for full musical mixes or other dense, complex material. But do remember, it's fairly intensive on your CPU. Complex Pro is also similar, but it's a special warp mode that's not only good for full mixed material, but it's especially good for dealing with material that contains vocals. However, this is even more CPU intensive. Although there's no hard and fast rule to using all the warp algorithms in their specific use cases, but you can also experiment with them to come up with new and interesting sounds where the warp algorithm will affect the sonic quality of the samples that you've loaded into the simpler device. Using the warp algorithms in Simpler, you can also warp a sample to a specific length so that it fits the tempo of your current project. In this particular case, I have a recorded vinyl sample that is fairly long and has not been warped. and I've dragged that into a simpler device here and selected a small portion of the beginning of that sample. By switching the warp mode on and selecting warp as one bar, I can warp that particular sample to the tempo of the project that I'm currently working in. We'll be right back.